Sound, very good. Excellent. Now that we've totally butchered the integrity of the stream, we can continue. Excellent. I'm kidding, of course. I have no integrity. You gotta have shame to be shame. All right. We're gonna play on normal modo. Hey man, the occasional during stream tech issue is a hallowed trademark. Apache. You don't know what the difference is. I don't either. Now we'll just go with that. Okay, let me... screen filter. That looks terrible. Let's see. Sound settings. Game settings. Number of players. Option attack. I don't know what that means. Continue. Yeah, two continues is fine. Let's see. Yes, we can confirm that there is in fact sound. I'm guessing you missed the blow-up that was the first 10 minutes of the stream. Is this on Switch? Yes, it is. Looks 10 years old. Well, it's more like 20 years old. Okay. just twin stick. No, it's not. You hold a button to rotate. Oh! Hey there, buddy. Right behind you. This game wants to be Zero Vendor 2. The game is dying to be Zero Vendor 2. Wait, is it? Wait, it is. Yes, it is. So as I mentioned in the intro, during the intro, apparently they had to do a lot of rebuilding of this game from the ground up for this port. I'm not acquainted enough with this game to remember. It has been a very, very long time. Ancient obscure schmuck video joke. I'm not well versed enough in old schmuck memes. So close. Too close. I don't want to be surrounded like this. This makes me uncomfortable. Predict that the boat plane is a mech in disguise. Oh, you were right. You got it. I Oh! He got me. Oh, it's a double KO. Bump into the buildings, but you don't die. How does that make you feel, Shmo? Make you feel better? I bet it does. Whoops. That was my second continue already. Oh, what's he doing? That's not cool, dude. By the robot scooter. Whoops! I kind of left that. That was me just being dumb. That wasn't very good. talking about Zone of the Enders, I've been sitting on a copy of the second game for many years. It sits next to my copies of MGS3 Subsistence and Paper Mario Thousand Year Door. Games that I should play, but I don't. Game over. Okay. Comanche or the Hokum? I like the name. I like the shot. Yeah, judging. Oh, there's like a cutscene fast forward. Cool. Yeah, I noticed that it does like the 1-1 thing, and then it's like 1-2, 1-3, so hooray for loops. No, because this is stage 2, and then it says 1-2. Though this being an old arcade game, originally, I would assume that's for big-time scorers. Bomb look like. Oh, yo, we get options. It don't last very long, but a little bit of time only. We'll be right back. This song is almost really good. It's got like, what are they, kind of like bootleg Mega Man X guitars? So I like how every time you turn the aiming, or the aiming adjust off and on, you get like that little chirp noise. In the grand tradition of Pocky screaming every time you change directions with her in Pocky and Rocky 2. Laser beam yet? No, we haven't. It's a little disappointing. You get to see Rainbow and Mamizo too. It is. You are missing both nothing and everything. It is a very strange game. Save me for a co-op opportunity. Well, you are in luck, because we are going to have a fantastic co-op opportunity in just a few weeks' time. Sigh, didn't even see what hit me. It's alright. I'm enjoying it. Oh, that's right. Man, I dodged that last time too. Feels bad, man. I just gotta remember those blinking lasers. Getting back to full power is only like 2 or 3 power pickups. That is exceptionally generous. Very anti-Gradius. Yeah. As someone who loves Gradius. Yeah. But even no, even like other arcade shooters like Raiden Project, those games, usually you need several power-ups in that category to get to full power. To say nothing of the Gradius is the worst offender by far. Just die if you don't want CC. I might dispute that a little bit, but I also have never cleared Gradius 3 on anything other than, I think, normal. I died, alright. My iframes must have just ended. That's a little annoying. Oh, hey there. threw his balls at me. Kinda gross. Don't want your balls, dude. On the left floor. That looks like that builds up your... I guess it's not really your bomb. This doesn't really function as a bomb. Your special action, like summoning my options here. Oh! Nice spin to win, dude. Oh man, that is some top-notch piano MIDI. I love it. Anyway, moving on. Alright, all we got left is the command sheet here. Oh, there we go. Yeah, buddy. Shoots in the target that you were facing. That's actually kind of cool. I can dig it. Snap the aim onto the closest enemy. Yeah! I don't think the concept of twin stick shooters hadn't really solidified at this point yet, for better or worse. I mean, this was 2001? Yeah, 2001. Oh! Ran into the part of the train. Oops. fifth down one. Whoops, I flew right into that one. Hard not to argue with the Apache just because it's got the homing missiles, the homing bomb. It's definitely has the most utility. The options on the Hokum are pretty good, whereas the stationary turret here is really like only good against big targets and bosses. Yeah, the damage on the DPS on the laser itself doesn't seem too good, but the penetration is actually really, really strong. Just with the way that the game is designed, being able to swing around with the lasers does a lot of work. Oh, you can actually set out multiple. Set out multiple buddies. It does change things a little bit. Actually, it would have been better to set two of the buddies right on the side here. So I can take down one and start to get the other. Oh, I ran right into that one. That was on me. I really like the detail on the landscape underneath, on the background there. It's probably actually like some kind of satellite shot. It probably, it might very well. Oh yeah, no, yeah, look at that, it definitely does. That's right, this is the balls in the face guy. Rotate around the earth enough, it loops too. are correct. This game definitely wants you to use your options, that's for sure. The game is not stingy with the resources. Also, I don't want to be here. This is very awkward. Mashing my bomb button like it actually meant something. Ah! Ah! That's not fair! It's too quick. Let's see what happens at 605. New high score, yay. Let's do the Apache again. You definitely have to collect a lot more for this bomb. Which, given that it's a hard homing, very heavy hitter, that makes sense. Thank you. one thing about the Apache is that you can basically mash the shoot button and not get any, and not lose your rate of fire, but get the homing on items. Said, I mean, given the trade-off for ease of use and power you get out of it, it's a little understandable. You didn't see what hit me. Presumably a bullet. That's usually how this stuff works. Thank you. get 1 million, which is definitely kind of, seems like it might definitely be that threshold where it's like, if you're good enough to get 1 million points without continuing, do you really need to continue? But overall, the challenge doesn't seem too extreme anyway, so maybe it's not a big deal. Setting. That's fine. When I say extremely upsetting, I mean like upsetting. Like that thing in Mega Man X8. I will have to take your word for it. No, dude, I flew right into that one. We're not allowed to see any significant amount of Stage 7. Oh my goodness, dude, I'm throwing it. Thank you. Oh, that's right. Instant lasers. I blow up again? I did blow up again. I didn't even see what hit me. That's all right. I like how there's a normal then arcade. Actually, no, you know what? Let's see what the game's like on very hard. Close thing to lunatic, and I'm pretty close to calling here. I gotta be up early tomorrow. I gotta start chilling out sooner than later here. I was expecting to go child mode. I was actually gonna do easy, but. The Zero Gunner 2 respects me enough to add an easy mode, but didn't. That's only made me halfway. They didn't give me big anime titties, so. Complete disrespect. getting chased and then blow him up in time. That's alright. Oh, that's definitely a different pattern. Side of the screen. That's why I'm not moving. Got it. Oops. Yeah, that was my own fault. Oh, what? I know that's not how this game works. Very hard doesn't seem that much more difficult. Like the patterns are a little bit more complex. I've noticed like enemy bullets are bigger. Some of them are. For the most part, seems pretty tame. Plane. Yeah, dude, professional bridge engineer. Giving you my real 2 cents on this. That is a visual novel. I forget what it's called. That is definitely a visual novel. That I'm using a different bomb than I am. Let's see. It seems nothing really to else to crank up in our options, is there? Game settings? We can start with max everything. At what point does the game just let you choose infinity continues? This is... There we go. Nice. Perfect. Yep. After 99, it lets you go to unlimited. Alright. Is this the Psycho Shmup Collection? It is not. This is the standalone release of Zero Gunner 2 for Switch. This is actually my first time playing this in a very long time. No, we'll give the Hokum one more try. That way we did each one twice. Should we crank our lives continues or go down to easy? Does it really matter? It might not matter. Continues? Play on very hard? Oh wait, no, we gotta do this right. Thank you. Okay. I do like the whip on this shot, though. It's super comfy. In some way, because didn't I fight this guy on stage 2 last time? Wait a second. This guy was the stage 3 boss. Wait, this game's been switching it up on me. Man, I was looking at chat. Does switch it up on you. And yeah, 360 degree rotation. The control for it is a little whack, but you know, it was 2001. I'm willing to forgive it. Fired it up. What was it, the first or second GDNCon? I think that's the only time I've played that in probably 15 years. I did not like that rotating bit on the front there. That was making me nervous. Ooh, I was looking at the boss, not at the bullets. That was on me. Load-bearing ship, call it good. Too bad. Soon. Oh man, I deserve that. That was just me being dumb. I absolutely deserve both of those hits. really sure how contact damage works with enemies, because I'm positive I've seen myself bump into things and then not die either. So I'm not sure how it works. Yeah, see, I just bumped into the scooter. Maybe I just got hit by a bullet that one time. I thought I had contact damage. Desperately trying to follow you. Yeah, I noticed that. You can tell that this game is actually 3D. And despite everything, most everything operating on a 2D plane, it is a 3D space because they're still tracking you, but you're on a different horizontal plane. That's not nice. suckers. We're reaching the stuff I haven't seen yet, and it's actually kind of dunking on me now. Suddenly a monster. Alright. You can roll whatever way you want to game. But does this count as doing the Torgo right here? Much of an ending. I mean, we don't even get to find out that the monster had, like, the brain of our little sister inside of it or something, like last week. Something to make you just suddenly go, I think that's what Cloud Phobia was. I'm not 100% sure what that ending was. I didn't know you watched the VOD of Luminous Avenger X. Thank you, Inti. That was Zero Gunner 2 for Nintendo Switch. Didn't even beat my last high score. Sure didn't. You know, pretty decent little game. if you ever want to check it out yourself. It is available on the Nintendo Switch eShop for, I can't remember how much it is, not much. $6, $8, something like that. And it is coming out, I think it's next week, in a compilation. Psycho Shooting Stars Alpha. They're actually releasing two separate compilations of Psycho's games, Alpha and Bravo. So yeah, I enjoyed it. I could play it again one day, maybe in another 20 years. Oh, that sounds depressing. Anyway, do stay tuned for next week when somebody will be playing something on Zayu's The Hitbox starring Shutero. I have been your host, Torgo Higgins. What's going to happen next week? Who even knows? But it'll be great. Probably. Do watch out for our other shows, too. Alternate Boundary at 12 noon on Saturdays with Skylar Silver, where he plays Toho fan games. And then our flagship show, weekly Toho Roulette, at 8 p.m. Saturday evenings, where Buckminst and Left-Handed Schmo, or one of our guest hosts, will spin the wheel and play a random Toho game. Also, keep an eye out for GBN Con on Saturday, February 15th, when we'll be doing a most-of-the-day stream, just doing all kinds of stuff. We all get together and stream tons and eat junk food, and it's great. We get to enjoy the food. You guys don't get to enjoy it so much. That's for us. That part isn't for you. But until then, guys, have an excellent week. Stay safe, and we will see you later.